Fleming got me crazy.
You push Fleming on that McCullough thing, there's gonna be big trouble, I'm telling you.
McCullough's innocent, and I can't get the goddamn Fleming to even look at the evidence, Jay. What do you want me to do?
You don't threaten a judge.
You don't threaten a judge!
You do me a personal favor? Put this on. Shells. I got Fleming first thing this morning.
Give him my love. A tie. I like it.
It's Fleming's favorite color.
All rise. Criminal Court of Baltimore City is now in session. The Honorable Henry T. Fleming presiding.
Be seated.
If Your Honor, please, for the first matter, the state would call case number 577-46898, State versus Robert Wenke.
Mr. Wenke, may I ask you to step forward, please?
And how many times have you been before the bench, Mr. Wenke?
3 times, Your Honor.
Mm-hmm. Once for assault, once for arson, once for grand larceny, and now we have indecent exposure. What's the matter, Mr. Wenke? Can't you decide what you want to be when you grow up? You got anything to say?
Yes, Your Honor. I'm a loyal Colts fan.
You are also a revolting, despicable scum of the earth who should be taken out and squashed like a cockroach.
Judge Fleming, I object. My client has not been found guilty yet.
You're absolutely right, Counselor. Let's see, it's now 9:40. At 9:41, he will be guilty. Find the defendant, Robert Wenke, guilty as charged. Sentence to be imposed at a later time.
Time, Your Honor, I would like to request that Mr. Wenke's bail be continued.
Bail is revoked.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Your Honor, please state the now called indictment number 577-46899.
Oh, it's good. That's very good work.
Thank you, counsel.
Very nice. Colts fan. I need Colts. That's terrific, Wenke.
You do know. The big White House. You know, with the fat columns out in front on Greenway Avenue. Guess how much that house is worth on the market today.
Oh, I don't know.
Take a guess.
$7 million. $243,000. Now, that's some nut I've got, huh? That's okay. I get enough accident cases this year. I'll be all right.
Maybe I ought to stop throwing out banana peels.
Listen, recess is almost over, and all I've got left is this illegal lottery case.
Did you know that there's a guy eating something off your table?
Huh?
The guy you're prosecuting?
Yeah.
He's eating the lottery tickets.
Holy shit. Get the hell away! Get
out of here! Don't swallow! You son of a bitch!
My client!
Get there! Get there! Don't swallow!
My client!
Get out of here!
Yeah, well, we're trying to get him off.
Swallow!
You can't do that!
Gentlemen, need I remind you, you are in a court of law? Now let's proceed in an orderly fashion.
Does have anything further to add?
Your Honor, it's I guess I should request a recess so that my client could get something to eat. He's obviously very hungry.
My client, McCullough. Could I see him for a minute?
Sure, Mr. Curtin. Hold your hand out.
Mr. Kirkland, what happened?
I just want to reaffirm what I said to you yesterday. We're going to get you.
I know you're trying, Mr. Kirkland, but this is crazy, you know?
I know it.
I mean, you told me you had the evidence that proves I'm innocent. I mean, it does prove it, doesn't it?
Yes, Jeff, you're innocent.
And that there Judge Fleming agrees with you, right?
Right.
Well, if everyone agrees that I'm innocent, how come I'm going back to jail?
Roland.
There's enough proof, Jeff. It's just that the court won't accept the proof.
Why not?
Well, there's a law. There's a law which says that evidence must be submitted within a certain time period. And our evidence came in 3 days late.
What difference does that make? What difference does it make if it came in 3 years late? They got the proof they need.
That's
they
not.
Let me go. I don't understand this.
Judge sent me to jail.
He knows I'm innocent.
Wait a minute.
What's going on here?
Jeff, it's just going to take a little more time. That's all. Any other judge would have let you out, but this guy Fleming, he goes by the letter of the law.
I don't understand that.
Jeff, I promise I'll get you out.
Promises he'll get you out, buddy. Don't worry.
Judge Fleming, I want to apologize to you, sir, for my behavior in the courtroom the other day.
I don't want to hear your apologies. I don't want to hear anything you have to say.
Well, that's understandable, sir. It's just I thought that maybe we could discuss this McCullough case, you know, you and I, man to man, off the record, sir.
Look, if you're going to try to make a deal with me, you might wind up right back in jail.
A deal? Deal? No, sir. No, sir, I'm not trying to make a deal. Look, sir, I can understand your strict enforcement of the statute, but what I can't understand is that my client's constitutional rights are being denied.
Don't you quote the law to me.
My client is innocent.
I don't give a shit about your client.
Mrs. Tate wants to talk to you. Her son broke his leg again, neighbor's driveway. And Bricker wants to know if your client will settle for $60,000. You can reach him at the club. Oh, you have three new clients coming in today. One's a whiplash, one's divorce, and the other one has something to do with amnesia. I don't know what it is. Roger, what are you doing?
Well, foam.
That's because it's deodorant. And today is Tuesday, so don't forget to visit your grandfather. And you have to be back in court at 2:15.
Coffee, please.
You want some coffee?
Sherry, stay with me today, dear. I need you today.
Arthur! Arthur!
Aye, Judge.
We gotta get together this weekend, huh?
Well, you know, you're the only one I've been dating these days.
Come on now. You promised you'd go flying.
I gotta tell you, Judge, you know, I'm not too fond of anything that takes place off the ground. Heights. I don't know. I got a thing about heights.
Come on, this is flying. It's different.
How high up do you go?
How high up do you want to go? Come on, it'll be good for you. Sure. Besides, it's lonesome up there.
Why don't you take your wife, Judge?
Last thing we did together was get married. Now, come on, Arthur. Now, you promised me, remember?
All right. What time?
Sunday morning, 10 o'clock.
You always carry that thing with you?
There's law and there's order. And that's order. Hey, you like egg roll?
Yeah.
Good. Come on, let's get out of here. Easy, easy, easy. All right, you got it.